We'll never know if one of those checkpoints could have saved the life of a boy killed in a wreck last March.
Tonight, a man whose license had been revoked is charged with murder in that crash, but he'd been in a lot of trouble long before that.
KNBC's Martin Augustine has the story live. Martin?
Laura, that boy, Damian Slayton, died after 30-year-old Clayton Ramon Dunlap got behind the wheel of an SUV and began driving at high speed here down the eastbound lanes of Gregory, often swerving into oncoming traffic, before barreling headlong into a car stopped in the westbound lanes over there, waiting for a light to change here at Gregory and US 71.
12-year-old Damian Slayton never stood a chance. Sitting in the back seat of the car his mother was driving, Clayton Dunlap, prosecutors say, smashed into that car while speeding through here in the wrong lane, the violent collision killing Damian. Police saying Dunlap smelled of the drug PCP. 2 weeks later, Damian's mother recovered enough from her injuries to speak out.
I think, was there anything I could have done? And no, there's not. I stopped at a red light. You know, there was nothing I could have done that could have saved my child's life.
This is dashboard camera video of Kansas City police pulling a man over. He'd been driving erratically. It is March 6th. Watch what happens. The man running from police is Clayton Dunlap. In seconds, he's leading police on a chase reaching 70 miles an hour. But a police helicopter kept after Dunlap, the pilot notifying pursuing officers that Dunlap appeared to be giving up. You can see in this video Dunlap out of his SUV and getting down on the ground.
What's your problem, man?
Still, this bail document shows that Dunlap was released a few days later on the promise that he'd be back in court. He'd certainly been there before. Dunlap had already lost his driver's license in February of 2007 when Kansas City police stopped him for speeding and crossing the center line. His punishment, 30 days in jail to be served on weekends. But three times over the next few months, these letters went out to the judge who sentenced him, saying Dunlap had failed to surrender to do his time. He eventually went to jail, but by the end of 2008, he'd been caught three more times driving without a license. And when he led police on this chase, he was wanted for violating his probation on those traffic charges.
It's frustrating, but we do the best we can.
Jim Knatzer is the Jackson County prosecutor. Clayton Dunlap's traffic violations for driving with a revoked license are among 1,500 similar cases clogging Jackson County courts. And even as alarming as his behavior is here, there's no jail space for all these chronic offenders who drive without a license, especially with other cases demanding more attention.
When you prioritize them against violent criminals such as murderers, robbers, rapists, child abusers, and even DWI offenders, They don't get the same priority as those cases get.
Clayton Dunlap was supposed to be back in court on March 29th, the crash killing Damian Slayton happening March 27th. Now, prosecutors take these steps to go after these chronic offenders. They say they'll try to get two misdemeanor convictions against them. Any charges after that, prosecutors will then pursue those charges as a felony. With the conviction of a felony, that gives prosecutors many more options for punishment, including prison time. Reporting live, Martin Augustine, KNBC 9 News. Larry and Laura.
Martin, thank you. And on April 20th, Jackson County's presiding judge issued an order that more background information on defendants requesting bail be delivered to judges who are making that decision. Prosecutors are in favor of that order.